We were talking about what Michael Robinson from the NFL Network said. He believes that Washington's next starting quarterback will be Teddy Bridgewater. And there seems to be a split. A couple guys okay with it. Cakes and I, not really for Teddy Bridgewater. Let's go to the phones. 800-636-1067. Jacob's in Stafford on line two. Jacob, what's up?
Hey, what's going on, Junks? Hello. I think every football team fan should be desperate for not just a bridge. And so I'm much more inclined to give up a third rounder for Darnold than I would be for Bridgewater, because he's 23. He's had problems in the past in college. Of course, it hasn't shown in the pros yet. But he's got 1 year, and he's done. He's a free agent. Why not go for a guy who could potentially be more than just a bridge? I mean, we've had bridges. Where's a long-term answer? If you don't do that, just draft a guy because he's on a rookie deal for 5 years. I don't get the point in trading for a vet who hasn't done anything. He hasn't done any winning in the pros. What's the point? We already have enough of not winning.
Well, I don't have full confidence. I know that EB's wanting to kick the tires on Darnold. I don't have full confidence that Darnold's going to be any better in the Washington. I'm swayed by, watch the video of Chris Sims flexing about his picks? Remember, Chris Sims was attacked because last week when he put out his quarterback ratings. And when he put out his quarterback ratings, number one, he had Trevor Lawrence number two. Mm-hmm. And beyond that, he got a lot of heat because he had Kellen Mond ahead of Justin Fields, and he had Kellen Mond ahead of Trey Lance. And people were grilling him about his quarterback rankings. And so he put out this video flex of his calls in the last few years.
Mm-hmm. They're pretty good.
And, you know, he basically said Darnold was going to have a bunch of turnovers in the pros. I mean, he pretty much nailed, like, the guys who were going to flourish.
He hit, like, on Lamar. He hit on Josh Allen. I mean,
he was one of the few who said, he said out of that whole draft of a bunch of first-rounders, he said Lamar Jackson's the best.
Right.
Well, look, again, I'm not saying that Bridgewater is the guy, and I'm not saying you trade a third rounder for him. I don't know, but all the names that we've kind of thrown out there in the past 3-4 weeks, because we kind of knew it wasn't going to be Alex Smith, they're kind of all the same. I mean, maybe there's more upside on a guy like Darnold because he's younger and he was drafted higher, but I don't know if Darnold's available. I mean, we assume the Jets are going to draft a quarterback, but we don't know. All the guys that we've thrown out there, the Fitzpatricks, the Mariotas, the Jameses, the Bridgewaters, the who am I forgetting? Trubisky.
Carr.
Yeah, I mean, they're not going to win Super Bowls. But you got to have someone there with some experience to help you win some games, even if you're trying to groom a younger guy.
I bet you, I haven't looked. I'm kind of perusing right now, that Darnold's numbers are the same as Bridgewater's.
More turnovers,
yeah. A lower completion percentage. His passing yardage, I mean, Cakes, he threw for 2,200 yards last year.
Well, brutal. He was also banged up a little bit.
Brutal. All right,
the year before that, 3,000. His rookie year, 2,800.
Okay, but Cakes isn't lobbying for Sam Darnold. It's not like he's saying, I don't want Teddy Bridgewater I want Darnold.
I'm much more anti-Bridgewater than I am pro-Darnold.
Right.
Yeah, you don't
trust
want
me.
Don't put
Darnold
on him.
You should be more pro-Bridgewater than Darnold, I think, actually. When I look at it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm off Darnold.
How about I'm pro-neither? Can I be pro-neither two names?
Give me a guy.
He just told you he'd roll with Heineke.
I'd roll with Heineke over Bridgewater.
I would too, but they're not going to do that.
So you're telling me you think Heineke would be a starting quarterback for 16 games?
I'm not saying that you don't bring in somebody else into the room. But I'm saying if you're going to bring in Bridgewater at $18 million, my math says Heineke, way better value, and probably is going to give you about the same results as a Bridgewater.
Take the money out of the equation. Take the money out of the equation. They might cut him. Take money out of the equation. Nobody thinks Bridgewater's worth $18 million. Take the money out.
Although that's not a high price for a starting quarterback for 1 year.
Yeah,
it's not. Starting quarterbacks make at least that. But go ahead.
To me, Teddy Bridgewater is another version of Alex Smith. He's not very good at his job. He's just kind of mediocre. And he gets paid.
He gets paid a lot of money because
there's a dearth of quarterbacks in the NFL. And good for him. I hope he makes $100 million in his career. I just don't think he's very good at playing quarterback in the NFL.
I get sliced for cakes, the GM.
He's just not.
He's not. But again, you're not going to sign him for a five-year deal. You're not signing him to Alex Smith.
I understand.
I think you better have someone behind him.
I think Rivera, unless he could get Trevor Lawrence or Zach Wilson, looks at the crop of rookie quarterbacks and goes, meh, am I really going to hitch my wagon to Mac Jones for the next 5 years? I think he's more of a bridge quarterback guy because he's not going to be here for 10 years. You think Ron Rivera cares what happens to the Washington football team in 2031?
No.
No.
But who do you think he doesn't. Do you think Rivera looks on that roster right now with one quarterback signed and says, I think we're all right. I think we're okay.
No,
I think we'll bring in Kyle Allen as a backup.
Set the bar higher than Teddy Bridgewater.
Who?
That's all.
Give me a name.
Cakes.
I don't have a name. You're better than Bridgewater.
He does. Tyrod Taylor. He said him 100 times.
Ty God, by the way, had a three-year stretch that Teddy Bridgewater would kill for. Now, I understand this is from 2015 to 2017. But Ty God, when he was with Buffalo, had 20 touchdowns, 6 picks, 17 touchdowns, 6 picks, 14 touchdowns, 4 picks, and a bunch of rushing yards, too, and rushing touchdowns.
Those are the same numbers.
They're very similar.
Teddy Bridgewater has never had a 20. Better. He's never had a 20 and 6 season.
They're marginally better.
Running numbers are better. You guys
running numbers are passing numbers are marginally better.
You're stretching.
You can say what you want. Listen.
I can't believe you're arguing Tyrod Taylor.
His rushing numbers, by the way, in those three seasons, 568, 580, 427. Pummels Teddy Bridgewater. Pummels
it. It was 6 years
Line
ago.
Them up. The numbers
I know,
are better than Tyrod.
A long time
they
ago.
They both stink.
But Cakes is right. We're arguing Taylor
I don't
over
know
Bridgewater.
That Cakes is right.
He's right. Just put the numbers next to each other.
He only mentioned two stats. What did he do? What was his passing
yardage
numbers?
The most important stats. Rushing and throwing.
What were his passing yardage numbers those years?
Let's go to Shannon
Hold on. Hold on. I want to bring up a point.
Okay, 14 games, 3,035. 15 games, 3,023.
Nothing. The same.
15 games, 2,799.
He doesn't pass for a lot of yards either. The same thing.
I didn't
say
he passed
for a
ton
of yards.
He passed for a lot of touchdowns. More than
Bridgewater. A lot more.
A lot?
20? A few more.
Give me a season where Teddy Bridgewater has 20 touchdowns. I'm waiting.
20's nothing.
I'm still waiting.
He could do it next year.
I can't believe you're hanging your hat on 20 touchdowns.
It's bad.
It's barely won a game.
All I'm saying is... better than Bridgewater's production. And that was
like
that was 5 years ago. Now we're in a hyperspeed offense where you should be throwing 25 to 30 touchdowns. And Bridgewater just rolls out there throws 16 or 17.
Well, hold on a second.
Mediocre. Terrible.
Hold on a second. Bridgewater was playing well in his second year, okay, getting better, and then he has a serious injury. All right.
Understood.
And then he misses 3 years, basically.
Yeah. And then he
comes back, and okay, he didn't throw for 35 touchdowns, but he completed 70% of his passes.
And by the way, he basically passed for 250 yards a game, which you could say is nothing, but it's not like 160 that Alex Smith was doing.
Then don't blame him for the
record.
Alex
Smith had a couple 300-yard games.
Well, I'm sure Teddy did too.
I can't believe we're arguing Tyrod Taylor. All right,